Sorry, I've been listening to the Cruisin' World OST and I can't get these songs stuck out of my head. Anyways, let me turn that off. Hey everyone, Chun Chun Maro Zenny here, and how's everyone doing today? Good to hear. Me? Well, I'm kind of freaking out a little bit. Because in some sort of fever dream, I purchased myself a 1/7 scale figure of Megumin from the anime Konosuba, made by the self-proclaimed luxury figure manufacturers Estream. They're down there. Estream. Which in turn cost itself a pretty penny. So yeah, I'm a little freaked out. More than I've ever spent on a single figure before. It's funny, throughout my couple years of collecting, I keep telling myself, I won't purchase anything over $100. I won't purchase anything over $200. I won't purchase anything over $300. I haven't hit 400 yet. This was just under 400, but including shipping and then cost a little over 400. Well, what's the point of waiting? I think I've waited long enough. Let's get her open. Let's get her. No, that's not gonna do. Here we go. Nah, I ain't feeling this one either. Let's get something a little better. Oh, yeah, here we go. Here we go. This is pretty good. Right here. I'll stain on this. That's more like it. A little dusty. Yeah. For a novelty sword, this thing's got some edge to it. It's actually got some sharpness to it. I still can't believe this is happening. I can't believe I bought this thing. Like, it's not real until it actually showed up on the doorstep and it's like in my hands. There it is, baby. I love her name right up front, Megumin. You know who you're getting. Explosion version. I like how it's just called the explosion version. It's very fitting. How do you pronounce it? Shibuya or Shibuya? We all know which way is funner to say. Oh my god, I can't believe I'm doing this. Okay, this box has got some heft to it. Ooh wee wee, ooh la la. Is this like a certificate of authenticity or something? Probably the nastiest smelling box I've smelt so far. Smell like doo-doo. Smell like dookie. Okay, inside here is her cape, her hat, and staff. So one worry of mine and many others was, since these are such big, elaborate figures with big, elaborate set pieces, people were worried about damage during shipping and whatnot, and stuff snapping and breaking, which unfortunately I believe has happened with some of the ReZero figures that Estream has put out. That's why I went ahead and got insurance on this one. I ain't playing around, boy, so if anything snapped, I can send her back. Or if I snap anything, shh. Okay, here we go. Where do I start? I just pull the whole thing out. Here she comes. Wow, it's actually much lighter than I thought. I believe we actually was asking that question on our episode of Figuratively Speaking, how much these Estream boys weigh. I'm caught! Caught on a spike. Okay, looks like everything came in one piece. Now the daunting task of setting her up. Ooh, I managed to put it together without breaking it. I think that deserves a drink. Cheers, everybody. We're on a successful purchase. It's not a can of Pocari Sweat, but the powdered stuff does just fine. Thanks, homie. I think I put a little too much powder in. Oh yeah. I guess I just want to shout out my friend Aquaholic for introducing me to this anime in the first place. His only recommendation was, it's a really funny anime, you should watch it. I was like, okay, sure, why not? I'm not gonna lie, it took me a while to get it. I didn't understand it at first for some reason. I think till like the second to last episode I figured it out. It's basically the Seinfeld of anime. It's an anime about nothing. I think once I let that go, that nothing was going to happen, I started to enjoy it more. And I actually found it really funny. It's probably one of the funniest anime that I've seen so far that actually made me laugh out loud. It took one very bad Figma and one kind of mediocre scale of Megumin to drive me over the edge and make me want to purchase this and go full out. Thank God she made it in one piece. I haven't broken her yet. But in true Fig Ultra fashion, it's not over till the fat lady sings until I finish this review. I think it's a good time to start the review right now and go over all the details that she comes with.
Way back last year, on January 2nd, I proclaimed during my Kitar Megumin review that this Megumin was the only one to save me from my mundane Megumins. Burn me once, shame on me. Burn me twice, can't get burnt again. That's when your man's got emotionally desperate, threw his wallet at the monitor, and went all out on this bad motherfucker.
That's my bad mother.
If this thing turns out to be crap, I'm casting my own explosion spell on it and shipping it back to Eastream's HQ in a body bag. Anyways, let's see if I can crack my knuckles a little bit. There we go. Let's get into it. There's really no justification to this purchase. I'm basically just banging my head with a hammer cartoon style here. Here she is in her classic getup from the show. Yellow triangles line the bottom of her bright red tunic. She wears a thick leather belt, because why not? Is it a dress or a long shirt? The more I think about it, the more confused I get. Never mind. My favorite, fingerless gloves, props on the painted nails. She stands cocked and ready in the power stance as her shiny leather boots dig into the ground. Knowing Megumin, the leg wraps are just for show, or either she lost her other black stocking in the dryer. That big, flowing, dark brown cape gets violently tossed around by the wind created by her explosion spell. You want to know the color of her panties? Well, you gotta buy the figure for yourself! Of course, Megumin isn't complete without her big floppy hat. I don't know about you, but I see the boogeyman from Nightmare Before Christmas, or the Harry Potter hat. I do like how the tassel on the end of her cap looks like a little puff of fire. And no, of course, I did not forget about Chomusuke.
Here comes the girl. Hello, girl. Welcome. There she is. She is here.
That's right, it's our winged feline friend, the real shot caller of the game. She points towards the horizon, or at a castle that's ready to be used as target practice. It looks like, to me, Megumin's in the process of yelling out her trademark catchphrase as her bright, fiery red eyes glare ahead. That's right, if I can only guess, she's most likely casting an explosion spell. Whoa, I just noticed how big her staff is. No, I guess that's about right. It's taller than she is. She sternly grips it around the wraps and prepares to fire off the spell. I love how she blasts off this super powerful spell with one hand, which is casually caught floating off the back end. She's got the upgraded purple orb thing at the end of her staff as it begins letting off blinding multicolored flares of light. But that's not all. The mana begins to manifest itself into an inferno of winding and twisting magical flames. Starting at the base, the flames rage and harshly rise up, beginning to create small vortexes that wrap around our little pyromaniac, warping colors from brilliant reds, deep purples, and dazzling oranges. I don't know, but either way, she stands on top of her summoning circle as that big booty blast is powering up. And it looks damn good, if I do say so myself. Okay, I know we were having fun, but we gotta slow things down and go over setting her up. She comes pre-attached to the base, so unless you have a reason to take her off the base, never remove her from it. Never. Her head simply pops off at the neck, which you will have to remove to put on her big honking cape. When looking her up online, I noticed a lot of people were saying she was a nightmare to put together and nothing simply fit together. Well, they were kind of right, but she was definitely way easier to set up than my scissor bay. The cape is the hardest part to put together. You will have to stretch and twist the two tabs in order for it to fit into her shoulders. I didn't do anything crazy to mine, just take your time and keep working at it, and the cape will eventually slide into the peg slots with a little force, unfortunately. And make sure to hold up Megumin tightly while pushing the cape on into the slots. Then you'll have to pull back on the effects part to fit the little notch on the end of the cape into the hole on the blast effect. Hey, at least there's only one slot you have to attach. That's it for the cape. Next, poop-diddy-scoop her staff hand, then plop on her head at free will. She's now ready to drain all her mana in one single glorious blast. Now that we've taken the full tour around this little girl, we can head to my likes and dislikes. One thing I learned is to never face Megumin in a battle of rock, paper, scissors. Well, I'm relieved to say that I got a lot of likes for this one. So let's get into them. The whole figure in general is proportioned very well at 1/7th scale. She correlates nicely with the base. Her cape flaps to the back of the effects and her wand just sticks out far enough to stand out from all the busyness. It looks like Estream took a page out of Alter's book and did an amazing job on the color and shading, such as using shadows and special colors to add the effects of natural light, like on the wraps on her leg and staff, or on her cape and cap along the yellow lining. Going over her with a fine-tooth comb, I couldn't find any sloppiness or molding deformities, and props on the coloring inside her hat, which is a lighter bluish like in the show. Her pose and effects are exactly what I bought her for, and they knocked that stuff right out of the park. She thrusts forward with momentum, leaving that exciting and menacing look on her face. The effects actually give a heavy presence on this figure rather than them just kind of being a piece in the background. Both the flame spiral and blast effects are awesome. The way they congeal together, breaking off or warping at random points, make it feel natural. I love how on the bottom of the base, the fire is being pelted and blown around from the wind by the spell she's casting off. Also, big ups for making it look like her orb is floating by attaching it to the flare effect rather than the staff itself. Same goes for the cape, giving an uninterrupted flow. And last for the likes is Chomusuke, because it's Chomusuke. What else do you need? Oh, and fingerless gloves, of course. And to my surprise, and maybe yours, I don't have any dislikes. No, seriously. I try to find something negative in my reviews to keep that status quo, but I only have maybe a few little gripes, like with her hat being magnetized. Magnets, how do they? The hat can bump or shift without having any actual true position. Attaching everything to her was a little bit of a hassle, but she was well seated to the base, so I wasn't too worried about anything snapping off. The little sideburn could have been stuck in there a little bit better though, and it would have been cool if the base had more details to it, like more fire or something. Or my dream base would have been her like standing in a field with grass and brush parting. But what we got works. Well, actually her special bonus faceplate you could order is kind of a waste. I could probably just print out a tiny eye patch myself and stick it to her face. Oh, now that we're done with this section, we can finally raid her. And she can go back to bullying me. Seriously though, that stun lock combo. This is the part of the review where I fake my way through three different categories and come up with a bogus 5 out of 5 score. The first category is photograph ability. How is this the only figure of her shooting her shot? She's like known as the explosion grill, but there are no figures of her at her best. So with this, I guess, being the only one of its sort, it's great to know that this one looks so damn clean. The way the cape is flung around and how she holds her staff gives her a huge impact. Literally. The little twinkles on the flare are cute. Her face looks great too. I can actually hear her shouting out, I like how on a bunch of figures of her, it's like an obligation to put Chomusuke in funny positions, and I can confidently say that this is the best one, with this one being a close second. Looking at her from different angles surprisingly works well. With her staff pointing directly at you, she looks pretty intimidating too. With her goofy and childish demeanor, it's easy to forget she's actually pretty badass. Next up is quality. With this whopper of a price tag, she better be top notch. Well, rest assured everyone, not only does she honk the honk, but she tonks the tonk too. The effects are sturdy and mounted to the base. You can even pick her up from them. Ooh. She seems pretty well affixed too. I was expecting the cape to spring out of its sockets on me multiple times while moving her around, but they're stuck in there like glue. Even the peg on the little effect piece. Her BFH and staff stay put. The paintwork is legit. Look how the wraps have layers. They could have just simply painted them to look like they were layered, but nope. Her hair whips around nicely and matches the atmosphere of her crimson red eyes. And let's not forget, Commander Chomusuke is stuck up top there nice and firmly. I can sleep in peace knowing she's built like a tank. Last category is Smug Megumin and Comfy Chomusuke out for a stroll. I'm giving Megumin, the Archwizard of the Crimson Demons, an exhilarating 5 nice explosions out of 5.
Nice buckets!
Well, it's my final thoughts. I think the effects are just tasteful enough to stand out but not completely take away from our girl herself. Am I still disappointed in myself for spending this much cash on a figure? Of course I am. But it was, thank God, still worth it in the end. Konosuba is a great show, and Megumin, even though it's a goofy name, is a great character. Will I buy anything else from Estream? No. Absolutely not. No. 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 No.
So with as nerve-wracking and wallet-breaking as this figure was, I am very happy to have her in my collection. And finally, after all these years, I have a Megumin figure that I'm proud to show off in my collection. Oh, will I spend this much ever again? Probably not. Okay, with all that being said, thank you so much everyone for joining me today. If you'd like to help support my channel and my wacky ass reviews, you know what to do. Subscribe, like, comment, check out all my other social medias. I'm always posting there. I've tried to keep up on everything. Instagram always has pictures. Twitter always has updates and such. Discord's just a place to hang out in general and goof around. My Hobby Link Japan affiliate link is always there for you to click on and help support the channel financially. So much love. You all are the best. I love you so much. Have a great day, everyone. I'll see you later.